Hi, my name is Carl and I'm from NAS. I'll be showing you around our LumaLink app. LumaLink allows you to quickly and easily configure your NAS streetlight controller via wireless connection. This is especially handy during testing or initial rollout of the controllers, but can also be used later on to make your technician's job much easier. Before we continue, I will say that the LumaLink app is still evolving. This means that your app might look a bit different from the one shown in this video, as we make improvements and additions over time. Also, please note that LumaLink only works with streetlight controllers with firmware versions 1.1 and up. When you first open your LumaLink app, you will not have access to any streetlight controllers without the proper access keys. If you haven't yet received your access keys, contact NAS support and we will help you out. Adding access keys is simple. Click on Access Keys, then click on Add from File, and choose your desired access key file. You should then see your access keys added to the list. If you go back and click on Start Scan, any streetlight controllers you can connect to will show up with a blue background. Devices you don't have access keys to will be grayed out. The only devices that show up in this list are NAS streetlight controllers. If you can't see your NAS streetlight controller here, please make sure your controller is powered on and LumaLink advertising is active. While LumaLink advertising is active and ready to connect, the LED on the controller will flash blue. By default, LumaLink advertising is only active for 4 hours after the first LoRaWAN join. After that time, you can send a LumaLink config packet to reactivate LumaLink advertising. This is done for security purposes. If you're already connected via LumaLink, you can also configure the advertising mode from the app. When connecting to the device, the first thing you see is information about the device itself, as well as anything you would need about its LoRaWAN connection. If necessary, you can even set a specific N1s here, but we advise you not to touch this unless you really do know what you're doing. Other features include geolocation, which allows you to set coordinates or an address for your device, so it's easier to differentiate from the possibly hundreds or thousands of other streetlight controllers you may have. Light control allows you to temporarily set a dim level manually, either by adjusting the slider on DALI devices or by turning the relay on or off on devices without DALI support. Fade time allows you to control how quickly or how smoothly your lamp changes between different dim levels. Use this to avoid abrupt lighting changes. In this video, we've used a 1 second fade time. As you might have already guessed, anything you would usually control while LoRaWAN messaging can also be done through this app. This includes things like packet interval configuration, dig input configuration, checking metering info, and more. Setting up your profiles or astronomical calendar settings is also much simpler to do using our LumaLink app. We've included handy graphs for you to better visualize the different dim levels during the day. Before we end this video, I'll also walk you through the firmware update process. Go ahead and scroll all the way down and click on Go to DFU mode. After that, click on Select DFU file and choose your firmware file. If you don't have the required firmware file, contact NAS support with the dev UI for your device and we will gladly provide the necessary files. Finally, once you've selected your desired firmware file, click on Start Upload and the update process will start. This shouldn't take more than a minute in most cases. Once the controller has finished updating, it will restart and rejoin, which will be indicated by the LED flashing green while joining and staying green when joined. You can then click on Connect and then go back to Device, where you should now see the new firmware version listed under Device Information. To learn more about the specifics of what you can achieve with your NAS streetlight controller and the LumaLink app, check out the links to our documentation in the description of this video. Thank you and have a good day.